Hello, my name is Tom Phillips. I am the director of the Digital Theological Library, the non-profit corporation that owns the Global Digital Theological Library. The mission of the Global Digital Theological Library is to provide a comprehensive library in religious studies to schools in developing nations that have a core part of their mission as religious studies. Let me share a screen and show you how the library works. We are glad you are here and interested in the library. This is how you use it. You go to globaldtl.org and you will see this screen. You can simply type in any topic that you are interested in, say the book of Philippians, and hit return. When you do, then you will see this screen. You can narrow down your search over here if you just want articles or you just want books. If you want most recent content from the last 5, 10, 25 years, or a custom date range. Then if you want to read, say, this item, when you click on it, you will get a screen, an authentication screen like this, where you will enter the barcode authorization code that we sent to you. And then when you do, you will access the content like this. It will often have this accept cookies. So you hit accept. Then you come down here, you can look at the book here by simply clicking on the download. You can download it, you can save it. In this case, chapter by chapter, sometimes you can save the entire book, but if you want to read, say, on chapter 3 of Philippians or chapter 4, you simply click on here, begin to read, or you could download that chapter for yourself. That we also like to show people in the Global Digital Theological Library the advanced search function. The advanced search, you can limit to keywords or subject phrase or title. If you know the ISBN or the ISSN, the item you're looking for, if we have it, you can find it in here. And again, you can search by format. So if you just want books or articles, you can also limit by publication date. One of the other things we like people to see on the Global DTL is the research aids. If you come over here, we have research aids like Bible dictionaries and encyclopedias that we have limited. So you can send your students here, or you can come here as a student and look. If you want a Bible dictionary, click on this link. And we have these dictionaries. You click on them and they'll open up as that book did earlier. One of the other things we like to show people, introductory text. So if there's a class, say, on hermeneutics, you just click on here and you can read that text. You can assign that text to your students. We have paid fees for this, so this is all legal. They can download it, they can print it. That's all entirely legal. Introductions to Hebrew Bible, various topics here in New Testament. This has been a very quick overview, intended to be a very quick overview. We thank you for your time and attention. If you have questions, we are happy to talk with you. Thank you.